New research reveals thousands of donated kidneys are thrown away or left unused each year, many of which could be used to save lives. This, as a Minnesota company works to develop its own kidney transplant alternative. Dr. Jeff Ross is the CEO of Eden Prairie-based Miromatrix. Welcome and thanks so much for being here with us.
Thanks for having me.
You know, when I saw this, that this was going to be our segment today, the first thing I thought was, why are so many donated kidneys tossed, especially as the niece of someone who died on a waiting list for a kidney?
Yeah, I think that's the sentiment of a lot of people when the study came out. And what the study showed is about 3,500 kidneys a year are being discarded. Now, many of those are lower risk kidney or higher risk kidneys because they're coming from elderly patients and they have other medical conditions, but other countries are implanting those. So the question is really, with this tremendous need of 100,000 organ, 100,000 patients on the transplant waiting list, why are we discarding these? So we're not only looking at that, we're also looking at what else can we do to help those numerous patients that are on the list.
There are so many people waiting. When you think about it, it's a big football weekend. We could fill up U.S. Bank Stadium with folks who are waiting for a transplant. Yeah. Everyone may not be able to get one, so what are you guys working on as far as an alternative?
So we're really looking, you know, with that 3,500, that certainly makes a difference, but it's a far cry, to your point, 100,000 that could fill a stadium. So our technology, we actually take existing organs. So we take organs that were discarded from pigs as part of our natural food chain. Then we remove all the cells, and I actually have one in front of me here. And what we actually do with it is remove all the cells, essentially wash the cells out of it. It's kind of like gutting your house.
Oh, wow.
And then we take all the cells out, and what that allows us to do is then take human cells and place them back inside of here.
So he's going to show us. We've put on our nifty gloves.
So if you want to take a look at this, and I invite you to just kind of hold this. This is what a kidney feels like when all the cells have been removed from it. So it has the same shape. It has the same vascular structure. Mm-hmm. Has everything needed to re-engineer it. So we don't have to build it from scratch. We're able to now put it into a bioreactor like we have here and then infuse cells back into it.
And this is something that could eventually or one day be transplanted in someone in need of a kidney?
Absolutely. Our goal is to essentially eliminate the kidney transplant waiting list.
You know, that sounds incredible. Realistically, how long could this take?
Yeah, we're moving along. I mean, we got a team of engineers and scientists at Eden Prairie working hard on this, making advancements every day. And, you know, we're targeting about 3.5 years before we can be in human clinical studies with this.
3.5 years before a clinical study. In the interim, what other advancements do you want people to know about that are like happening now?
Yeah, so a lot of people are working. It's such a big problem. So people are working on dialysis. How can they change that? How can they bring that into the home before we get to an ultimate solution like this? And actually, HHS and the American Society of Nephrology put together this thing called Kidney Acts. It's actually redesigned dialysis to offer up prizes to really bring technology like this forward. And we were one of 15 teams that won that this year.
Oh, wow. Well, congratulations to you, and thank you so much for your innovative work. Keep us in the loop. We want to follow up with you. If you missed any of today's segment, that's okay, because we're going to post this on care11.com, as well as a link to their website. Just look for our 11 a.m. show page. I'm also going to share this on my Facebook page. Still ahead at 11.